Today, we all know Elon Musk as the leader of two of the most revolutionary companies in the world, SpaceX and Tesla. But before getting involved in the creation of either of these companies, Elon Musk was actually working hard on building up PayPal. And at one point, Elon Musk was actually the CEO and majority shareholder of PayPal. But despite this, as you guys read in the title, Elon Musk was fired from PayPal as CEO. So what happened? Well, starting off, let's take a look at how Elon even got involved in PayPal in the first place. Elon first took a step into the online banking system in December of 1999 with his company X.com. X.com was simply an online bank that performed all the same functions that a regular bank would perform, such as giving out loans, offering savings accounts, and managing investments. Elon hired John Story, who was previously an investment banker, as the executive vice president of X.com, and Bill Harris would serve as CEO and president. As for Elon Musk, he served as the chairman of X.com. With the executive team in place, Elon founded X.com using $25 million from himself, Bill Harris, and the popular venture capital firm Sequoia Capital. Moving on to how they actually built the company, X.com would offer 20 bucks to individuals who opened a checking account with them. Aside from this, they also offered a $10 incentive for referring a new user to X.com. These generous incentives proved quite successful, as X.com quickly garnered 100,000 users within just 2 months of launching. At this point, the largest online banking company was E-Trade Telebank, who had 130,000 customers. So clearly, X.com rose to the top quite rapidly. But garnering customers and deposits is just half the battle. As a bank, you have to keep customers and deposits in order to run a profitable lending service. And unfortunately for X.com, they had some security concerns. The internet was still in its very early stages, and online security was little to none. X.com themselves admitted that it was concerningly easy to transfer money into X.com from other people's traditional bank accounts. Despite these early challenges, X.com was able to slowly grow trust and their customer base. Meanwhile, a computer scientist named Max Levchin was formulating his own take on online banking. He had already founded three startups, from which he was waiting on a cash out in excess of $100,000. Unsure of what exactly to do next, Max would attend a lecture led by Peter Thiel at Stanford University. Soon after, Max would pitch a business idea to Peter Thiel. The idea, of course, suggested entering the online banking business. However, Max wasn't concerned about opening an online bank itself. The market was already quite saturated in comparison to the size of the market at the time. So, instead of opening an online bank, which would be very expensive due to the extreme amount of marketing they would have to embark on, Max suggested creating encryption software that could be licensed to existing online banks. This sounds like a pretty good idea, but people didn't really care. Yeah, most people signed off online banking as dangerous due to a lack of security, but the introduction of encryption services didn't really change their mind, as you might expect. Given the lackluster launch of this proposal, Max and Peter shifted their focus within the encryption market. Instead of offering encryption services to other online banks, they started offering encryption services directly to customers. But this wasn't in the form of an online bank like their competitors. Rather, they focused on a service that could provide users with encrypted IOUs that they could send to each other through emails and the web in general for a small fee. They named this business Confinity, which is a combination of the words confidence and infinity. Anyways, as eBay started to pick up traction, so did Confinity, as they were the most popular option used by sellers and buyers on eBay. As a result, Confinity was doing pretty well for a startup. However, Peter Thiel was concerned about the competition. The service they were offering wasn't that hard to rip off and just offer for a cheaper price. Considering this, Peter Thiel believed that the key to convert their initial boom into long-term sustainable success was to grow their dominance in the market and then go public. With that being said, Confinity would soon merge with X.com, and they would create the conglomerate that we know today, PayPal. Originally, Bill Harris would become the CEO of PayPal, Elon Musk would become the chairman, and Peter Thiel would take on the position of CFO. Though this merger gave the new company a strong position within the online banking market, the two companies didn't get along all that well due to vastly different company cultures. X.com had a very uptight corporate culture, while Confinity was quite laid back. The differing approach led to several conflicts between the former leaders of either company, Bill Harris and Peter Thiel. One day, these arguments would boil over and Peter Thiel would quit. Elon Musk, who highly valued having Peter Thiel as an executive member, would call an emergency board meeting where they would basically come to a compromise. Bill Harris would be the one that was booted from the company, Elon Musk would switch over to being CEO from chairman, and Peter Thiel would replace Elon Musk as chairman. This mostly resolved the internal management disputes between the two companies, but the future of the company was still a hot topic. At the time, PayPal was a dominant player, but this didn't mean they were profitable. And the truth was, they were burning millions upon millions of dollars due to their super generous incentives. Thus, logically, Peter Thiel demanded that Elon Musk resolve the severe cash flow issues with the company. But for some reason, Elon Musk was focused on other trivial matters and flat-out bad ideas. First of all, Elon Musk wanted to rebrand PayPal as X.com again, for who knows why. This was clearly a terrible idea. Just from a surface level, it's not that good of an idea to focus on rebranding when you're burning through mounds of cash, especially when that name is X.com. But more importantly, the name X.com was objectively proven to be a bad name through public polling. This is because the average person preferred to not send, receive, and/or store money with a company that sounds like it's related to the adult industry. So I think we'd agree that this wasn't the brightest of ideas. Aside from this, Elon Musk also wanted to invest in switching PayPal from being run on Linux to Microsoft systems. Sure, Microsoft may have been a better idea long term, but to the company's board, this just came off as super distracted when Elon should be focusing on finances. These concerns would explode when Elon Musk took a small vacation. This wasn't because they were mad that he took a vacation per se. They probably knew that he worked super hard and a small vacation wasn't the problem. The real problem was that they thought that Elon Musk was distracted from fixing the financials of PayPal, and Elon taking a vacation gave them the perfect opportunity to fire him. When Elon was on vacation, the executive team led by Max Levchin would lead a little revolt against the company board. They demanded that Elon Musk be fired, otherwise they would all quit. And with Elon Musk not being there to ease concerns and or make a compromise, the board gave in and fired Elon Musk as PayPal CEO and replaced him with Peter Thiel. Of course, Elon was not happy at all with this decision and was quite fired up that Peter would agree to fire Elon after Elon had gotten Peter back on the team. And to this day, Elon has only kind of gotten over it. But really, Peter didn't mean for this to be personal. He simply agreed that Elon was not leading the company in the way that the rest of the executives or the board wanted him to, so he agreed to fire him. This is further reinforced in how Peter would go on to help Elon fund SpaceX. And Peter owns 12% of SpaceX to this day. Moreover, they didn't buy out Elon or run the company into the ground or anything like that. In fact, Peter ran it really well and refused to settle. For instance, during the cash out, PayPal was looking for a buyer that would pay a minimum of $600 million. Both Google and Yahoo would refuse this price, and eBay would essentially say, "We'll give you $400 million, take it, or we'll crush you." But Peter wasn't put off by such threats, and stood steady at a minimum of $600 million. Since a deal couldn't be made, he would take PayPal public, and the market would value PayPal at a whopping $1.2 billion. And soon after, eBay would end up buying PayPal for $1.5 billion, out of which $180 million would go to Elon. And today, PayPal is worth well over $200 billion. So Peter was able to win a pretty good deal for everyone. The PayPal team was able to relax bankruptcy concerns, and they received a very solid payout for what the company was actually worth at the time. Meanwhile, eBay was able to grow it to much more over the next several years. So at the end of the day, though Elon Musk played a key role in the early development of PayPal, his leadership as CEO was simply too long-term focused when the rest of the company just wanted to be profitable, or at the very least, lose less money. Thus, unfortunately, he got fired. But I think it ended up working out pretty well for Elon as well, as he got a $180 million cash out, which he was then able to turn around and invest in companies with more long-term visions like himself. Do you guys think firing Elon was a mistake? Comment that down below. Also, if you guys thought this video explained the situation well, then make sure to drop a like, and consider subscribing to see more questions logically answered. But until then, I'm Hari, and I'll see you guys on the next one.